Now we are ready to plot Z2 at O2 on the Smith chart. Right here is the 2, and the negative part is about 0.56, so this point right here is Z2 at O2. Now let's draw a straight line from the center through that point out to the edge, because we're going to use that when we rotate the distance D2. Now we need to rotate from O2 to minus D2. That's going to be towards the generator, because out here is the source of the plane wave. So the distance that we're going to go is D2, which is 0.33 meters. We need that in wavelengths because we're working on the Smith chart. So let's divide by the wavelength in region 2, which is 0.8 meters. This tells us that we need to go 0.4 wavelengths toward the generator. So let's read this value right here. That is about 0.256, and I want to go to 0.4 wavelengths, so I'm going to go 0.256 plus 0.4, which is at about 0.656 wavelengths. So that would be about right here. So I'm going to rotate D2 towards the generator. Let me just draw a straight line from the center out to this point that I'm interested in. That's how far I'm going to go. Now let me take the length of my Z2 at O2, put it right here, and that is Z2 at minus D2, but this is for the lossless case. So I've done my rotation, but I haven't yet done my attenuation. Now the next thing that I need to do is read the magnitude of the reflection coefficient for the lossless case. And if I just bring that down here on the reflection coefficient axis, it's going to be about 0.33. The next thing I'm going to do is attenuate that, so I'm going to multiply that by e to the minus 2 alpha 2 d2. And the number that I'm going to get for that when I put in D2 is 0.033 meters, and alpha is 2 nepers per meter. I'm going to get 0.8699, about 0.87. When I multiply that by 0.33, I get a new value, which is smaller, of about 0.29. So I'm going to calculate a reflection coefficient of 0.29. This is the magnitude of my reflection coefficient for my lossy case, and that's what I'm actually going to plot here. So that's going to be about right there. That is Z2 at minus D2 for my actual lossy case. Now let's read that. So I'm going to read Z2 at minus D2. The real part is about 1.1, and the imaginary part is positive, and it's about 0.55. Remember, this is still normalized. So that's the value that I have for my normalized impedance right here. I want to take that across the boundary. Remember, it's ohms that cross the boundary, so I need to get this value in ohms. In order to do that, I'm going to denormalize by multiplying by eta 2. That's going to give me a value in ohms. The number is 45.4 plus J 24.3 ohms, and that is Z2 at minus D2. Now the next thing that I know is I can take my ohms across the boundary, so Z1 at O1 is going to be equal to Z2 at minus D2, which is this value right there. That's what I just calculated. Now in order to put that on the Smith chart, we're going to need to normalize it. We'll do that in the next video.